Welcome to the PLM Time Machine, where PLM experts will take us on a worldwide tour of the evolution of the PLM software. With the challenges of the past and the advancements of the present, let's see who can navigate the timeline the best. My name is Yash.
And I'm Sarah, and today we have something really, really interesting lined up for all of you. So we're going to be walking down the SAP PLM memory lane, but with a little twist. So let's meet our experts and know how long they have been in this PLM mission.
Hi, my name is Stefan Ziegler, and my current role is Business Development Manager for the region Middle and Eastern Europe. Over the last 15 years, I'm at SAP with a focus on the complete SAP PLM portfolio. So let's see if I can recognize the very old PLM screens.
Hi, my name is Carsten. I'm heading the cloud development for SAP PLM. And I'm joined SAP 1997, so that's why I'm probably part of this time machine history lesson.
Hi everybody, my name is Dave Kramp. I'm Director of Sales at LeverX. I started my SAP PLM journey in August 1998, version 3.1 or 3.2 was my first SAP GUI. So I've been doing SAP PLM for a couple years.
Yeah, hi everybody. My name is Andreas Madlencnik. I belong to the global team, so-called Center of Excellence, within the digital supply chain. I'm with SAP quite fresh, right? So about 2.5 years, but I'm in the PLM domain for about 13 years plus.
My name is Mark Landrosh. I work primarily in our discrete products. And I've been involved with SAP since around 2006. I was part of a partner company called Right Hemisphere and started working with the development groups as a technical liaison to help embed our visualization solutions into the SAP PLM 7 release. We were then acquired by SAP in 2011, and I've been here since.
Hi, I'm Achim. I'm Senior Vice President of Business Development at Dietze Software AG. I'm actually in the PLM industry since over 25 years and since about 2015 on the SAP side of PLM, really. So I have a perspective from a sales and business development marketing perspective, working with customers, understanding their needs and delivering solutions that they want and that would help them, really.
What are the rules of the game?
So, Sarah, our experts would be in pairs, and they would be shown some screenshots of the SAP PLM software, and they would try to guess which software or which time that screen is from and share some insights about the topic.
Well, let's get into it then.
History of PLM software at SAP.
I mean, it's highly sophisticated because it's written. My SAP PLM cFolders.
Oh, God. Folders.
Yes.
I remember. You too?
No.
It must be around 2005, I would say. And for customers, it was a fascinating product because it was for the first time, at least in the PLM space, that we moved data from R3 at this time or ERP at this time out into a collaborative scenario. So we moved customer data. I mean, still it was on-premise, but we moved them to international teams. We moved them to customers, to partners. And this was a new concept, or rather new concept at this time. So we got many questions. How do you ensure security of the data? We have tons of customer fields. Can you expose those customer fields into the application? And this was an exciting application.
I think it was more than 10 years ago. Then we started with exchanging data from SAP PLM with the outside world. Mm-hmm. And this was the first year putting data out of SAP into the cloud and then collaborate with partners. So this is the predecessor from...
Even EBD collaboration,
exactly,
right?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. But looks a little bit old-fashioned, I think.
Kind of, yeah.
But in these days, we were top of the notch. So this was really a great solution, and a lot of customers used that.
We have plenty of customers that have implemented this. And I think maybe going back into the hot tub time machine here, you know, some of the interesting things is thumbnails. You can actually get a thumbnail to pop up and show, you know, so that was, you know, hot stuff back in the day. The PDX exchange, you know, how do you change those generic packages, the status management in here. So yeah, some very, 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 at the time, very cool stuff.
Be sure to catch the second episode of the History of PLM at SAP on the SAP Community YouTube channel.